love to remote to which making stuff down here in our place. And I found this photograph that's by photographer Jordan Z on the internet of what I think must have been like a Trojan horse that was made of cars and
money.
It's the Trojan horse from Occupy Sydney. I thought just to sort of really kind of a documentary watercolour.
And is the Liam Kelly sort of referenced to there?
It was just a little grainy photograph, and I've been asking everybody.
It's a knight, it's supposed to be a knight. It's actually a pony, it's called Occupony.
He's a knight. And I was reading, they thought it was a Trojan horse that was in the knight's
space. Well, they actually tried to get it into the Reserve Bank.
Sword, so I figured I thought it was not Liam Kelly, but there's certainly that reference there in the shape that resonates with Australians really strongly.
Once again, all made out of cardboard.
That's right, all this fantastic tubing, you know, cardboard boxes, and then there's people. It's sort of like formed, so it's people inside making a photograph. I was really impressed. I think we find that when you look at, you know, not just Occupy Sydney, which and Occupy the rest of the world, which this last year has really had artists at the forefront, but when you look back through the history of protest, which I've kind of been doing in my work for a little while now, you just see so many artists involved, and I think it's probably, for a start, someone like me, who's actually not a good speaker, wants to express something about the issue, then we're going to go to what we do, which is what we do with our hands and our brains, and so we make art or we make music or we make theatre or make dance or film or whatever is appropriate. And I just think you can't ignore that in the protest movement because it actually expresses something kind of on a different level that the general public actually can take on board. And it's another way of understanding what issues are. So I think it's always really worth looking at what artists are doing because they do work in this non-verbal way, which is really powerful. These other images I've made, it's a few years old now, but they seem to be appropriate for this project as well, because they're really about how a group of people getting together to protest about something, rallying or protesting, becomes some kind of organism that's more than the individual parts, and it develops a personality and a kind of a way of engaging with the rest of the world. That can actually be for good or be for bad. So it can develop this kind of sense of moral compass in the crowd. So these works are really about what is that organism about? And what personality is being expressed? And how does it sort of communicate to us individuals some sort of something that's kind of scary anyway? So that's basically what this work is about.
So that was water cannon in New Delhi?
This is a water cannon in New Delhi, yeah, so it's actually flipped back over itself. So it was a way of working with it to sort of express something about the patterning of our, you know, humanity and how we keep doing this sort of same thing over and over again. And the first thing that I found the photograph was I was struck by how much it looked like an ancient Greek sort of proscenium sculpture with a tympanum and earrings called the Elven Marbles or something. And I thought it would be interesting just to sort of put it back and turn it into a pattern. And then, of course, this sort of war shark pattern developed out of it. And I thought, well, that's another level of sort of non-verbal, sort of instinctual communication that we all relate to and sort of see more in the picture than actually even the artist was trying to put into it. So I think that's working on another kind of level than the pure sort of reason documentary. And these other ones are actually images from student protests in the US on the university campuses.
And they go back to the civil rights movement.
Yeah, they're going back a little bit to the last quarter of the 20th century.
But you started the mass movement series with the former Fleur.
Yeah, that's probably where the actual work that I've done so far is the actual watercolours I've made. But I've been really interested to find things, photographs, going right back into the late 19th century, photographs of unionists gathering, kind of protests and gatherings like that. Not many photographs exist, but some of them are amazing. You see like the back of old wagons with people dancing jigs, because you know, where I come from in Queensland, a lot of the people involved in the development of the union movement were actually of Celtic origin, and so a natural thing to do when you've been gathering people was to dance. So you'd see this sort of like something that was about a strike, but there's a guy up on the back of the wagon doing a jig. I find that's incredibly uplifting in a way. It's a really positive thing in those sorts of protests, and it's what gives people the energy to go on as well, I think. So,
well, it's been Fiona, and we'll see where everything is. But,